Hello, now we solve example 8. The two-dimensional flow of a non-viscous, which means inviscid, incompressible fluid in the vicinity of the 90 degree corner of the figure is described by the stream function. Psi is equal to 2r square into sine 2 theta, where psi has units of meter square per second when r is in meters. Assume the fluid density is 1000 kilograms per meter cube and the xy plane is horizontal, that is, there is no difference in elevation between points 1 and 2. So, as you can see here, we have a 90 degree corner, and these are the streamlines of the flow field, and here we have two points. We need to determine the pressure at one of them in part B. So in part A, we need to determine the velocity potential. So first, before determining the velocity potential, we need to check if phi exists. So for phi to exist, the curl of the velocity should be equal to zero. That means that the vorticity should be equal to zero and the flow should be irrotational for phi to exist. So first we need to make sure that the curl of the velocity is equal to zero. So the velocity vector in cylindrical coordinates is equal to vr into er, the unit vector in the radial direction, plus v theta into e theta, the unit vector in the tangential direction. So the relationship between Vr and Psi, so we have Vr is equal to 1 over r into del Psi over del theta, and V theta is equal to minus del Psi over del r. So Vr in this case, we should make a differentiation of Psi with respect to theta. So we can take 2r square out of the derivative, and the derivative of sine 2 theta is just 2 cosine 2 theta. So we have 2r square over r into 2 cosine 2 theta. So derivative of sine u is u prime cosine u. So we'll have vr equal to 4r into cosine 2 theta. And V theta, partial derivative of psi with respect to r, so minus del over del r of 2r square sine 2 theta. So we take sine 2 theta out of the integral, so minus 2 minus sine 2 theta into derivative with respect to r of 2r square, which is equal to 4r. So V theta in this case is equal to minus 4r into sine 2 theta. Then the velocity vector is equal to 4r cosine 2 theta into er minus 4 minus 4r sine 2 theta into e theta. So since here we have a two-dimensional problem, we just need to determine the curl of the velocity vector in the z direction, since here the rotation will be about the z axis, which is perpendicular to the xy plane. So here I've put for you a table showing all the del operation in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinates. So the curl of a vector A in cylindrical coordinates is as shown. Here it is written in terms of rho, phi and z, where rho is equivalent to r and phi is equivalent to theta and z is the same. So it is equal to 1 over rho into del of rho into a phi, the tangential component of a, over del rho minus del of a rho, the radial component of a, over del phi. So 1 over r del over del r of r into the tangential component, which is v theta, minus del over del theta of the radial component, which is vr. So 1 over r del over del r of r v theta, which is minus 4r square sine 2 theta, minus del over del theta of vr, which is 4r into cosine 2 theta. So 1 over r, we can take minus 4 sine 2 theta out of the derivative, and derivative of r square is just 2r. Minus, here we can take 4r out of the derivative, and the derivative of cosine 2 theta with respect to theta is just equal to minus 2 into sine 2 theta. So cosine u is, has the derivative of minus u prime sine u. So we will have 1 over r into minus 8r sine 2 theta plus 8r into sine 2 theta, which is obviously equal to 0. So we can deduce that the flow here is irrotational and phi exists. So phi exists since the flow is irrotational. So that is the condition for phi to exist. We need to have an irrotational flow. Then, in terms of phi, we have vr is equal to del phi over del r, and v theta is equal to 1 over r of del phi over del theta. So phi is equal to integral vr dr, and vr is just equal to 4r into cosine 2 theta. So we can take 4 cosine 2 theta out of the integral, and integral of r is r square over 2, plus of course a function of theta, since phi here is dependent on r and theta. Then phi is equal to 2r square cosine 2 theta plus a function of theta. Now let's take the partial derivative of phi with respect to theta. So we will have minus 4r square sine 2 theta plus del f over del theta. And this should be equal to r into v theta. So del phi over del theta is just r into v theta. And so r multiplied by minus 4r sine 2 theta. So minus 4r into sine 2 theta. Then this term and this term will cancel each other. So we'll have del f over del theta is equal to 0, then f of theta is a constant, and we can set this constant to be equal to 0. So it can be any constant. Then phi in this case is equal to 2r square into cosine 2 theta. Of course, we can draw this potential function on the graph of the streamline. So remember that the potential lines are orthogonal to the streamlines. So we need to draw lines that are perpendicular to the streamlines. So here is a potential line having a theta equal to pi over 4. Since for theta equal to pi over 4, cosine 2 theta is equal to 0, then we will obtain a line which is the bisector of the corner. So these are potential lines where phi is equal to a constant, and here are the streamlines with psi equal to constant. So as you can see that the distance between the potential lines is larger near the corner and is shorter away from the corner, and also it is the same for the streamlines. So the distance is larger near the corner and smaller near away from the corner. And if you can see at point one, the streamlines are closer to each other than at point two. So at point two, the streamlines are more distant. So we can expect that the velocity at point one is higher than the velocity at point two. And we will verify this using the calculations. So for part B, if the pressure at point A is 30 kilopascal, what is the pressure at point 2? So if the pressure at point 1 is 30 kilopascal, we need to determine the pressure at point 2. Since here we have inviscid irrotational flow, that means we can apply Bernoulli equation between any two points in the flow field. It doesn't have to be two points that belong to the same streamline. So for inviscid irrotational flow, Bernoulli equation is applicable between any two points in the flow field. So we can say that P1 over rho plus V1 square over 2 plus GZ1 is equal to P2 over rho plus V2 square over 2 plus GZ2. So here the two points are at the same elevation in the xy plane. So we can eliminate GZ1 with GZ2. So the pressure at point 2 is equal to P1 plus half rho into V1 square minus V2 square. So we need to determine the magnitude of the velocity at point 1 and point 2. So V square is just equal to Vr square plus V theta square according to Pythagoras' theorem, since Vr and V theta are perpendicular to each other. So if we continue the rectangle, we will obtain V. So Vr is 4r cosine 2 theta, and V theta is minus 4r sine 2 theta. So Vr square is 4r cosine 2 theta square plus V theta. So we can remove the minus sign, of course, since it is a square. So we should put 4r sine 2 theta. And if we take 16r square as common factor, so cosine square 2 theta plus sine square 2 theta is equal to 1. So the magnitude of the velocity square is equal to 16r square. So it is just dependent on the radial position. So let's see what is the radial position for point 1. So r1 is equal to 1 meter, and for point 2, R2 is equal to 0.5 meters. So V1 square is equal to 16R1 square, and R1 is equal to 1, then it is equal to 16 meters square per second square. Then for point 2, V2 square is equal to 16 R2 square, and R2 is half or 0.5 meter, so 0.5 square into 16, it is equal to 4 meters square per second square. So P2 is equal to P1, which is 30 times 10 to power 3 to convert to Pascal, plus half into rho, which is 1000, to V1 square, which is 16, minus V2 square, which is equal to 4, and we will obtain a value equal to 36,000 Pascal or 36 kilopascal. So you can notice that the pressure at point 2 is larger than the pressure at point 1. Or in other words, P1 is less than P2. So that's why V1 is greater than V2. So if the pressure decreases, then the velocity should increase.